Biophysicists are able to make incredible images at a multitude of scales, doing so to get a better understanding of how our molecules function. And to walk us through that process, I'm joined by Professor Dorit Hanein. Thank you so much for joining us. The first question is about your imaging and what imaging you're focused on. What unique insights does this technique allow us to gain?
So the type of imaging that I use is imaging that combine light microscopy imaging, live microscopy imaging, with high resolution electron microscopy. It's also have an acronym of like cryo-CLEM, which is the correlative light and electron microscopy. This combination of both techniques allow us to identify cells and look at molecules in cells in a functional state, and then decipher the state, the structural state, at high resolution, like single filament resolution at the nanometer scale.
How important is it to be viewing these molecules in vivo or as close to their natural condition as possible, and how are you able to do this?
So the importance, I would say, can be divided into two stages. The first thing is something that cryo-CLEM can do and no other technologies, imaging or structural technologies can do, is can look at those macromolecular in function in the context of the cellular environment. Our cells has about 10,000 different molecules, and what they interact with each other, when they talk with each other, this is actually what the cells do. So to able to look at molecules in the context is the primary goal and the primary advantage of this technology.
And you have brought some of these images with you.
Yes.
What are we looking at here?
So in here particularly, what you are looking at, the range of scales for your first question is, we can look at tens of microns to single nanometer scale. So nanometer is about 10 to the minus 9 of a meter. So we can hear in this one image, in the color coded that you can see, we are talking about tens of microns. And when you look at in the lower part of the panel, you're looking at the nanometer scale. So what we're doing in here in this image is we are trying to correlate a functional state of a molecule. Here is a biosensor, and we're looking at its activity state in the live microscopy when the cell is alive. And then we plunge, freeze it, arrest the cell, and we then look at those small areas that you have marked here in the rectangles, and we can image it with an electron microscope, with a technology known as in situ cellular tomography. And we can look at those filaments at the resolution that you see in these two bottoms. The red ones are the high activity of that sensor. The purple one is the low activity of that sensor.
How does this let you correlate or couple the information you're gathering at different scales? What example do you have of the kinds of things this can tell us?
So, for example, something that in this particular study we're able to identify is we're able to identify how an activity of a sensor manipulate or signal to the cell to generate different cytoskeleton arrangement. So this is a technology that allows us to look at the formation of this high stack of actin filaments represented here by the lines in here, and showing they are poorly aligned. They are very unique in density, whereas in the absence of the activation of that sensor, the filaments are very long, very, very aligned with respect to a particular direction. This kind of information cannot be obtained in other way today unless you use this technology.
These images.
Incredible. You'll be presenting this work at the New and Notable Symposium on Wednesday. What's the title of your talk, and why should people come to hear you speak?
Well, the title of the talk is Coupling Molecular Activation and Function in order to using several different imaging technologies. And why to come to this I just gave you a snapshot of a little bit of what we are going to present. And the information and the breadth of details will be more provided in the lecture. So I hope people find it intriguing enough to come and join.
Well, we want to go in depth with you. So thank you for now for giving us a preview, Dr. Dorit Hanein. Thanks a lot.
You're welcome.